My old twin bed was awesome. It served me really, really well, but now it's time for an upgrade. In this video, I'm gonna give you a sneak peek at my new DIY van conversion, van conversion 2.0, and I'm specifically gonna focus on my queen-sized three-panel bed. Let's go. Plus nuts. What you're looking at right now is the bottom of the three-panel bed, and I wanna quickly walk you through the design. For this bed, my buddy Jason made two steel rails that run on either sides of the van. These rails then hold the three panels that make up the bed frame. Everything is made out of steel, and then the top of the panels are made out of plywood. Most people, when they put a three-panel bed in their van, they use angle iron for the ribs, for the tracks. While this angle iron makes for a really good ledge for the bed to sit on, it also sticks out quite a bit inside the van. And my concern there was if I didn't have the panels on the bed, and I was just moving around in the back of my van, would I ever hit the corner of one of these angle iron pieces? Because if so, that would really hurt. So I conveyed all this to Jason and he said, why not just use steel tube as the rail? And that's exactly what we did. The steel tubing is attached to the side of the van with plus nuts. These are bolts that you drill into the side of your van, into the sheet metal. And then when you install them, they expand and really grab the sheet metal, creating a nice secure connection. So if you don't know about plus nuts, do some research because they're gonna be your best friends when working on your van. Additionally, Jason welded in a couple tabs that we just put screws into. And you know, this rail attaches in a couple extra places to the panels of the van, thus making it more secure. The three panels bolt into the rails in four places. And then the panels themselves also bolt to one another, thus making a more rigid platform, more comfortable for sleeping, that kind of thing. Right now you're looking at the raw steel. I haven't gotten it powder coated yet. Eventually I plan to, because the powder coating will make it moisture resistant. So if I'm ever camping in the wilderness and it gets a little dewy out, the bed won't rust. It's been a couple weeks and I've since gotten my bed powder coated. I got it painted in an electric blue color. I think it turned out really nicely. Big shout out to Powder Coating Systems in Tacoma. You guys did a fantastic job. Thank you very much. While I was powder coating the rails, as well as the bed frame, I went ahead and powder coated the little sprinter handles to match. And then I also got some of these coat racks at IKEA and got a couple of those powder coated because I figured, you know, it just looks a little bit more slick when everything matches. And this, the reason this is here is because I like to fold my towels over here, so when they're a little damp, this is a great way to dry the towels. That also makes them easy to access. So eventually when I get my van conversion all set up, I'll do a full video explaining everything. But for the scope of this video, I'm just gonna focus on the bed. And so I'll give you a few more pointers and then I'll sign off, because that's what I do. I also wasn't sure if the plus nuts and the screws would hold my weight, hold me and Kylie up. So I went ahead and powder coated some little brackets that I figured, if need be, I could attach somewhere right here, give some additional support. But these things are completely unnecessary. This bed is rock solid. It holds 2, 3, 4 people, no problem. The other night we were playing cards up there, 4 of us were playing rummy. And so we were sitting up here and no issues. It held us fiercely. So while I was at it, since I got the bed powder coated, I figured paint the sheets of plywood, just make them a little easier to clean, maybe preserve them a little bit longer. And I also painted the side panels. If you recall, they used to just be raw wood. I painted them with a nice little cream color for the same reason, so I could take a sponge and wipe them off and keep them a little bit cleaner. You can see right over here, this is where the plywood drills down through the side rails. And there's 4 of those places, 1, 2, 3, and 4. And this sort of just keeps the bed down. And another thing I did is I took some weather stripping, some sticky foam weather stripping, the type that you would put in a door, and I coated it all up and down the steel rails, because when the steel bed frame was resting on top of the steel rails, driving down the road, it would clink and clatter pretty loudly. So I just put a little bit of foam in between so as to dampen that noise. So I basically took foam and shoved it into every place where metal touches metal. And that has reduced the clinking. That's more or less my 3-panel bed in a nutshell. Thanks for watching. I hope you found this video to be helpful. For more information, check out the show notes below the video in the description. And as always, subscribe to this channel for more videos that are just like this, but completely different.